boys and girls, this is Earth Day week. So this week we're going to use one of my favorite books, The Whale's Song. Now, if you've heard this book before, you know how special it is. And if you haven't heard it before, you're in for a real treat. It is by Diane Sheldon, and the paintings are by Gary Blythe. And the music in the background is by Michael Gettle, and the piece that he's doing is called San Juan Suite. Lily's grandmother told her a story. Once upon a time, she said, the ocean was filled with whales. They were as big as the hills. They were as peaceful as the moon. They were the most wonderful creatures you have ever imagined. Lily climbed into her grandmother's lap. I used to sit at the end of the pier and listen for the whales, said Lily's grandmother. Sometimes I'd sit there all day and all night. Then suddenly I'd see them coming toward me from miles away. They moved through the water as if they were dancing. But why did they swim to you, Grandma? Asked Lily. How did they know you were there? Lily's grandmother smiled. Oh, you had to bring them something special. A perfect shell or a beautiful stone. And if they liked you, the whales would take your gift and give you something in return. What would they get from you, Grandma? Asked Lily. What did you get from the whales? Lily's grandmother sighed. Once or twice, she whispered. Once or twice, I heard them singing. Lily's great uncle Frederick stomped into the room. That's nothing but a silly old tale, he snapped. Whales were important for their meat and for their bones and for their blubber. If you have to tell Lily something about the whale, then tell him something useful. Don't fill her head with such nonsense. Singing whales, indeed. There were whales here millions of years before there were ships, cities, or even cave dwellers, continued Lily's grandmother. People used to say they were magical. Ah, people used to eat them and boil them down for oil, continued Lily's great-uncle Frederick, and he stomped out of the room. Lily dreamt about the whales. In her dream, she saw them as large as mountains and bluer than the sky. In her dreams, she heard them singing, their voices like the wind. In her dreams, they leapt from the water and called her by name. In the morning, Lily went down to the ocean, to the place where no one fished or swam or sailed. She walked to the end of the old pier. The water was empty and still. She took a yellow flower out of her pocket and dropped it into the water. This is for you, she called into the air. Lily sat at the end of the old pier and waited. She waited all day and all afternoon. Then as dusk began to fall, Uncle Frederick came down the hill after her. Enough of this foolishness, he said. Come on home. You can't be dreaming your life away. That night, Lily awoke suddenly. The room was bright with moonlight. She sat up and looked. She listened. The house was quiet. She climbed out of bed and down to the window. She could hear something in the distance, something on the far side. She raced outside and down to the shore. Her heart was pounding as she reached the sea. There, enormous in the ocean, were the whales. They leapt and jumped and spun across the moon. Their singing filled the night. Lily saw the yellow flower dancing on the sprays of the water. Minutes passed, or maybe even hours. Suddenly, Lily felt the rustle of the breeze on her nightgown and the cold nip at her toes. She shivered and rubbed her eyes. It seemed like the ocean was still again, and the night dark and silent. Lily thought she must have been dreaming. Then she stood up and turned toward home, and far, far away, on the breath of the wind, she heard, "Lily!" The whales.